haven't brought any pictures of Bucharest in my presentation, but you can see the city after a representation. See the weather will be all right.
I'll try to be as short as possible, and I'll try to explain you some situations. Somebody told me that it's not suitable to use the word problem, but to use situation. The situation that we are facing in the process of forecasting. The first idea, the main idea, is that economic forecasting and forecasting in general is a dynamic domain. The methods used to be valid some years ago are not anymore actual. The system is changed, the data is changed, the power of computation is changed, so we have to adapt to these new methods and technology. Of course, classic methodology is valid, but you have to adapt it to the new era. A big question that the forecasters are asked many times is why the forecasting is not accurate. Why there are so many differences between the forecasted values and the actual values. First, you may think that the person who made that forecast used the wrong method. Maybe the situation, but not all the time. Many times the problems are not in the methods used, but the data you are using for calculating the expected values. Many times the data you have to use is not as good as requested to have a valid forecast. The validation of data is an interesting process, and if you are not aware of the problems that can appear in the preliminary data, you have you may have wrong conclusions. A different situation, a more problematic one, is in some sensitive sectors. We are talking here about data manipulation. What means this data manipulation? That means the errors in the data sets are not arbitrary. The errors appear in this data set. These errors are inserted there. The data is corrupted by human touch. In these sectors, one of the sector with the biggest problem is the electoral system. The data in elections, the results of the elections, seems to be many times manipulated. And I'll try to present now a method used to identify if the data reported, the reported data, was or was not manipulated by any means by human intervention. The system that I will present has its roots in the past century, starting with the study of Simon Newcomb, who observed that the pages having the data about logarithmic values, the pages starting with low values like 1, 2 are more used, more degraded than the pages starting with degree 9. What this means? That means the distribution of the digits in random number tend to have a particular distribution. This particular distribution was developed later by Benford, and he demonstrated that the probability of a digit here I noted this digit with D, the probability of a digit to appear as the first digit in a series of data is this formula is logarithm decimal logarithm 1 plus 1 divided by D. If you look at the graphic, this is how the digits of the numbers are distributed in a series of data, and series of data which are not restricted by any has no restriction in the independent data. This probability, this distribution, and the green ones are the values calculated for the first digit of the data sets from elections. As you can see, the distribution follows almost perfectly the tested correlation. Also, the chi-square test suggests that more than 99.99% the sets are the same. The same results I have obtained also testing the second digit. Using the first two digits, there are slight differences between the Benford distribution presented here by this blue zone and these peaks that are above this blue zone or below. This is the single one test that has a little discussion, so to say. But if we have used the chi-square test, we can say that the results cannot indicate that the data presented by the Central Electoral Bureau, the data is manipulated. Even if we see a little modification, the results cannot indicate a strong modification. Of course, the study is not complete. We have to look into more details. We have to look also on the regional level. But as a general rule, when we test a data set, we cannot say that the analysis is correct after only one test. You cannot have it validated until you pass a lot of tests. And even then, there will always be a degree of unknown, and even only one test fails to be passed, the theory is invalidated. So, as a conclusion, this Benford law can be used only as a tool of validation and not just to be the only tool used for validation. You have to use also other tests. It is important to test the data before drawing any conclusions to see if the analysis can be based on accurate data, and only after that to use those data sets to make a valid prediction. So this is one of the tools that you can use to validate data like electoral data.
Thank you very much. Mr. Jula, like a specialist in the field of statistics, I have...
There's a question.
Excuse me.
So, which program do you use when you analyze and forecasting the data? You use all SPSS?
For this particular analysis, I didn't need views because the tests were introduced in Excel. The probabilities were calculated in Excel, and only for forecasting I use views or
yes. But mostly views I use. But for particular tests I use Excel because I just probabilities.
There is one more program for the forecasting, the weakest bet.
I don't know. In Turkey, generally you use
Windows version of quantitative systems for business.
A free alternative for AVIEWS, because as you can see it's pretty much pretty expensive, is the use of R. Simple R. Yes, it's an open source, free, a free alternative, but it's not as user friendly as AVIEWS. Also, AVIEWS is not very user friendly, but R is even less
complicated.
Yes, you have to write the code like in C, like programming.
One question.
Yes.
You know very well that when the financial crisis in Greece started, it was an opinion from the Eurostat that the statistical reports concerning the economic situation in Greece were corrupted. It's the problem of the statistical system used by Greece, or this is a human, very, very hard intervention in view to modify the statistical objective data. What is your opinion?
I think
like a specialist in the field of statistics.
I think it's a combination of the two. Because if you know that the system use has some drawbacks, you can try to use these drawbacks and to obtain the results, the needed results. Many times the analysts try to use a particular those methods that bring out the results they need. They know if they use different methods, they may obtain different results.
Yeah.
And they can, I'm not saying that they've done that, but they can use particular methods to obtain the
resulted.
Yes, I'm not saying that happened,
yes.
But
yes.
It is a possibility.
Thank you very much.